We are to start the topic of open source licenses. Okay. So in the last lecture, I was telling you that as we know, open source software, they are free to use, free to distribute, free to share, and you can customize it because you are having the source code available. Okay, fine. So we also licenses of the open source, they provide certain benefits to the user. Okay, like that day I was giving example of driving license. Driving license protects you from the penalties, from any fine which may be imposed you for breaking the traffic rules. Okay, because while driving, it is important and compulsory to carry your driving license with you, and you are to follow the rules laid down by the government. Okay, so what are the benefits which license provides? Suppose I am creating some project and some persons are voluntarily helping me out. They are contributing their efforts also. Some people, they from their own will, they are contributing to my project. Then they don't have to take any special permission for that. Right? I am the original creator of the project. I am the original developer. So I am provided with certain rights. Right? A license provides original creator certain rights. And if I am doing some work, I should get some due reward for it and due credit for it. Right? And later, nobody else should claim that this work is not done by me, myself. The work has been done by them. I am the original creator. I have done the work. Later, Arman can't say that the work has not been done by me. Rather, he has done the work. He should not claim his own rights on it. Okay? Now, first license is GNU GPL, General Public License. This is the most popular license which provide variety of rights to the user of open source software. Okay, what are the rights? We can copy the software. We can distribute the software. We can charge fees for the distribution of software. And since source code is available with us, we can make modifications also. Agar coding hogi, to aap coding mein change kar sakte. Right? So general public license is the most common license which provide variety of rights. Okay. Next is lesser GPL. The rights in this type of license are less as compared to original and the normal GPL. That is why the name has been given GNU lesser GPL. Okay. Suppose I am taking the license for the free software, then I can incorporate, I can use, I can change my free into proprietary. I can combine both. I can avail the benefits of both free as well as proprietary. Features of free as well as features of proprietary, both can be combined, both can be incorporated in this particular type of license. Okay, clear? Suppose I have used somebody's source code to make some modifications and I release the latest version. When I release my version, I release my copy to others, I also have to provide them the source code. If I am using the source code of somebody else, I too have to deliver my source code to others also. Okay. Third type of license is Berkeley Software Distribution. Please zara focus yahan rakho LCD pe. Don't try to divert your attention here and there. The theory is not so easy. You need to understand the meaning very carefully. Okay. Online class, am I clear up till here? Madhav, Mishti, Karanjot. Now, what is Berkeley Software Distribution? Berkeley Software Distribution basically is a family of permissive licenses. In the last lecture, I was discussing with you the meaning of permissive. What do you mean by permissive? Being a student of English medium school, you are studying English subject. General knowledge, as per your general knowledge, what do you mean by the word permissive?
That is totally
free. Free. One who is free, one who is not bound by any obligations. He is a very permissive child. Means he is free living child. He is not bound by any obligations or any restrictions. Okay. So very few restrictions are laid on the Berkeley software distribution license. It is of two types. New BSD license and simplified BSD license. Now in the case of new BSD license, or its another name is modified BSD license, the source code can be given in two ways. Either original source code, either in the binary form. When you get the source code in the binary form, that means you don't get the original. You get the encrypted copy of that. Like suppose I am to send message to Jay. One thing is I send message directly. Another way is I send coded form. Message to be converted in code, and I send the coded form to Jeff. Okay. Now, whether you use original or whether you use the binary, some conditions are to be taken care of. What are those conditions? First condition. If I am distributing the source code, original source code, I should retain the copyright, all the list of terms and conditions, and the disclaimer. Many times when you watch any movie online, the first thing you notice is disclaimer. The first thing you notice is disclaimer. Okay. What is the meaning of disclaimer? That day also I told you, suppose that I have written this document, right? And I send this document to you people with a disclaim, with the declaration that any error occur, any problem occur, I will not be liable for it. When you want to refrain yourself from something, when you want to quit yourself from something, कि अगर ऐसा कुछ हुआ तो मैं उसके लिए जिम्मेदार नहीं हूं, पहले डिस्क्लेमर कर दो. ओके. इफ यू आर सेंडिंग द कोड इन बाइनरी फॉर्म, देन यू हैव टू टेक फ्रेश कॉपी ऑफ द कॉपीराइट. यू हैव टू रिक्रिएट द कॉपीराइट, रिक्रिएट द टर्म्स ऑफ कंडीशंस एंड रिक्रिएट द डिस्क्लेमर. अगर तो ओरिजिनल सोर्स कोड है तो ओरिजिनल कॉपीराइट, ओरिजिनल टर्म्स एंड ओरिजिनल डिस्क्लेमर. But if you are sending the binary form, if you are distributing the code in binary form, then you have to reproduce the copyright, reproduce the terms and conditions, and reproduce the disclaimer. Okay. Third condition is, suppose I am to endorse or promote some product, I cannot use the copyright holder name. Like I have the copyright. Okay. और कोई भी दूसरा पर्सन मेरा नाम मिसयूज नहीं कर सकता. अगर वो आगे कोई प्रोडक्ट सेल कर रहा है या कोई एंडोर्समेंट कर रहा है, ही कांट मिसयूज माय नेम विदाउट माय परमिशन. विदाउट माय परमिशन एंडोर्स मींस हैंडिंग ओवर. ओके. सिंप्लीफाइड बीएसडी लाइसेंस, it also provides very less restrictions, but the only difference in this is that it does not consider any endorsement clause. Jaise endorsement clause BSD mein bhi padha humne, ispe koi endorsement clause nahi hota. The next license is MIT license, Massachusetts Institute of Technology license. बहुत ही ज्यादा लूज टाइप का लाइसेंस है ये, शॉर्टेस्ट ब्रॉडेस्ट एंड वेरी वेरी परमिसिव, वेरी लूज राइट इट प्रोवाइड्स, बहुत ज्यादा रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ले डाउन नहीं करता ये यूजर के ऊपर, जस्ट लाइक जीपीएल, यू कैन से जस्ट लाइक जीपीएल, राइट, कैन बी इजिली कॉपीड, इजिली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड, राइट, यू कैन सेल द सॉफ्टवेयर फ्रीली, नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑन इट्स शेयरिंग, नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑन इट्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, बट द ओनली कंडीशन हेयर इज that you are bound by the license agreement. Whatever agreement has been set up, you are bound by that agreement. Okay? The last but not the least is Apache license. This was the license which came as a short note question in the last year pre-board, in the month of January. This year, January, pre-boards, 2 marks short note was there, 4 rights, provided by Apache license. Rights are perpetual. Perpetual means forever. जो एक ऐसी चीज जो चलती रहे. Okay. Rights are worldwide, covering entire world. It's not hard and fast. They are prevailing in one country, not in another. Rights are granted for no fees, no royalty, no fees you are to pay for it. Non-exclusive. ऐसा नहीं है कि इसमें ये चीज इंक्लूडेड है, ये इंक्लूडेड नहीं है, ये वाले कैटेगरी के पर्सन के लिए है और इनके लिए नहीं है. इट्स अवेलेबल फॉर ऑल. इररिवोकेबल राइट्स आर इररिवोकेबल मींस राइट्स कैन नॉट बी चेंज, ऐसा नहीं कि वो चेंज ना हो सके. अ थिंग विच कैनॉट बी चेंज्ड, विच कैनॉट बी रिवोक, राइट. द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, द लास्ट कॉन्सेप्ट इज फ्रीडम ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. I give one live example to you people. You will get to know the meaning of FOI, freedom of information. Are you getting everything, na?
Yes.
Online class, am I clear with all the points to you? Madhav, Mishti, Karanjot, Parth, Prabhanur, Divita, Arshdeep, Japjot, Saharsh. All right. Madhav, it's very good that you are in the class. Good. Shabash. School ke display board pe ek circular lag gaya. One very live example I'm giving you. Later on, bring this example into your topic. Is that circular restricted for some students? Ki ye wali class pad sakti hai, ye wali class nahi pad sakti. Circular one, बेशक वो सर्कुलर आपके काम का नहीं है, बट एटलीस्ट यू हैव द राइट टू रीड इट. अ सर्कुलर विच इज पब्लिकली पेस्टेड ऑन द डिस्प्ले बोर्ड इज ओपन फॉर एवरी स्टूडेंट ऑफ द स्कूल, बिकॉज एवरी चाइल्ड इन द स्कूल हैज द राइट टू असेस द इंफॉर्मेशन. सिमिलर इज द FOI, फ्रीडम ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन. वट एवर इंफॉर्मेशन इज डिस्प्लेड or shown on public platforms, it is available to all. Jalandhar Bulletin, jo profile hai Facebook pe, it is open for all. For all the citizens of Jalandhar. Okay? Koi restriction nahi hai ki ye log pad sakte hai aur ye log nahi pad sakte. Theek hai? So what is the purpose of FOI? To provide clear transparency. What is transparency? Clear picture. Your result should be transparent. Your result should be clear. Okay? Government accountability. We are accountable. As citizen of India, we are accountable to government. Like you as a student are accountable to teacher. Accountable means answerable. We teachers in turn answerable to, accountable to principal. Principal in turn accountable to management, right? And suppose any corruption or any malpractices are occurring, to protect the users from that. Clear? Now comes digital divide. Again, I gave a live example. This is group one. This is group two. Group one is urban sector, living in urban area. Group two is in the rural area. Khushi, attention is not in the class, I guess. Please. Group two is in the rural area. Lot of resources and technologies and facilities are given in group one, but technological facilities are not provided in rural area in group number two. They are deprived of the technology. They are not getting the enough resources. They are not able to use technology much. They cannot avail the internet facility, or if they are availing, it is at very less rate. Gap aa gaya. ऑप्टिमम यूज तो नहीं हुआ ना रिसोर्सेज का. एक तरफ ज्यादा है, एक तरफ बिल्कुल नहीं है, और अगर है तो बहुत कम है. दिस गैप, दिस डिफरेंस इज डिजिटल डिवाइड. सम सेक्टर ऑफ पीपल यूजिंग टेक्नोलॉजी व्हाइल सम आर डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ. ओके, सो डिजिटल डिवाइड रेफर्स टू द गैप that exist between the demographics and regions that have full access to information, full access to technology, full access to internet, but those who do not have any access, or if they have, it is very less. In nutshell, in simple language, you can say digital divide means the gap that exists between the individuals, between the group of persons who avail the internet facility, all the modern and communication technologies, and people who do not have rights to access the modern technologies. Or if they have the right, it's very less. Ya to bilkul nahi hai, aur agar hai to bahut kam hai. Okay. Now, why digital divide occurs? In the sample paper of 10th class, this question is there. Okay. Within 1 or 2 days, I think CBSE will upload the latest sample papers as per the pattern of term one. It's expected. It may be late, but we are expecting that within a day or two, CBSE will upload the sample papers on its website. So keep checking the CBSE site for the sample papers. And once they are uploaded, you better take the printout of all for every subject and keep them in a file and discuss the sample paper in the class with the teacher. Like, you all are physically coming, so it will be convenient for you to carry the sample paper. And everybody must have its own copy. Don't share the copy. Okay, fine. Difference between rural and urban area, already I told you. Okay. Then socio-economic differences, discrimination between the people on the basis of races, income, education level, literacy rate, okay, and differences in the term of availability of internet facility, right? Now there is one note for you people. It can come as MCQ. Right to Information Act was passed by Parliament on 11th May 2005, but it came into effect on 12th October 2005, replacing the FOI Act of 2002. Right to IT Act, Right to Information Act, it was passed by Parliament on 11th May, but actual working mein kab aaya, wo functioning mein kab aaya tha? 12th October 2005. Okay. Digital unity. Now again, I pick up the same example, group one urban, group two rural. I divide the resources equally. If you are getting the modern technology facilities, you are able to access the technologies, you are getting the share, proper share, proper resources. The proper resources must be given to the rural area also. They also must have the right to access the technologies. जितने आपको रिसोर्सेज दिए गए हैं उतने ही इनको भी दिए गए. देयर इज नो डिस्क्रिमिनेशन कि यहां पे कम है वहां पे ज्यादा है या वहां पे ज्यादा है यहां पे कम है. प्रॉपर बैलेंस इज देयर. दिस इज कॉल्ड डिजिटल यूनिटी. ओके क्लियर. सो डिजिटल यूनिटी कैन बी डिफाइंड एज इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटी.